Hey guys, RestinJoy here. In this video I'll introduce you Enum permissions. In your RPG game probably there are NPCs, and almost for every action you have to check if they are permitted to do something. But there are just too many bools, and your class gets fat. So is there an elegant way to solve this? Of course! Instead of tons of bools, you could have one Enum for all of the permissions. With only one variable, you can hold up to 32 permissions, or 64 if you use long. We'll get to that later. Is this the only advantage of it? Of course not. It will also save us the trouble of checking, granting, and revoking multiple permissions in one go. Like this, instead of this. So, how does it work? First, we introduce a new enum called permissions. You see how the values are powers of 2. If you are too bad at math, or you don't want to type powers of 2, you can do it by binary, but I'm not sure if it will make it any easier. Speaking of easiness, let's see how it makes everything easy with permission templates. When you want to start a cutscene in your game, first, you have to check if your NPC can move, can do routines, can fight, and can interact with others. Then you would revoke permissions of getting input and being interacted, because it would be really sad if the NPC died in the middle of the cutscene like Cartman. In some cases, you would also grant some new permissions. To cover that as well, we have talking permission here. Having defined them all in your permission enum, your initiate cutscene method should look something like this. First, we check the permissions. Then we reserve current permissions in a temporary variable. Then we start the cutscene. Then we grant revoke rights back. If we did it with booleans, it would be much more error prone. Imagine a scenario where you would change the required permissions before entering a cutscene. Say you wouldn't want your NPC to eat during cutscene. You would add a new bool like can eat. Add a new temporary list for reserve, revoke permission of eating and enter the scene. It's quite possible that you forget to re-grant the permission to eat to the NPC, and the poor NPC will always be hungry. With enums, you could simply add these and keep your NPC fed all the time. This model is widely used for file access. Also, my good friend Epiphany at Night is developing an RPG game and he used this model for character permissions. See how the character can't get any input from us here, when waiting for the indoor scene to load. For those who want to get a good grasp of the underlying idea, we used bitwise here. What is bitwise? Simply put, an integer consists of 32 bits. And since enum is based on integer, it has 32 bits as well. From the first bit, we keep permission to move, do routines, be interacted, interacting others, and fighting, respectively. When we grant movement to access to the NPC, it becomes something like this. In mathematical terms, it means it's equal to 1. You can also inherit from long instead of int, so you would have 64 bits and permissions instead of 32. Finally, we have the extension methods, which make it easy to check, grant, and revoke permissions. Within this method, we check for all the permissions and return true if all of them are permitted. We say params here, so we can pass as many arguments as we like. Within here, we grant or revoke the given permission to the NPC. Within here, we can grant or revoke multiple permissions to the NPC. This is optional. I recommend you to declare templates and grant or revoke the whole template when needed, like we did here. Finally, even though I can't think of a useful real-life example, you can grant all of the permissions to the NPC, which will work even if we add new permissions later on. Keep in mind that we always use bitwise operators when checking, granting, and revoking enum permissions. Don't mix it up with regular and/or operators, as it will give you error. That's all for this video. You can find all the used code in the description. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If not, please tell how it could be better in the comments section. consider subscribing and following me on Twitter. See you next week.